Hello guys, here we are with Buddy. Buddy! And I believe he's got in his mouth wolf's ball. Yeah, he's got wolf's ball. That's why wolf is barking. Let's go see Wolf. And here we have Wolf. Wolf! Probably he's going to get the ball again. Wolf? No ball? Ah, yeah. Here's the ball. Okay, I will do that a few times. Before we proceed, guys, to what I'm going to show you today, I want to show you a special tool that I got. I received it today. I like it very much. It's called One Step Looper, and I will show you exactly what it does. For many times and many years now, I always seem to be low on rings. What I mean with rings, I mean with these rings that are used to tie almost everything. So I not only have to get more rings every time, but sometimes I need thinner or thicker rings. And I need some long rings for the sails underneath, and I don't have always what I need the time that I need it. But this tool here will provide the rings. It's very easy to use. You can have a loop that it's around 1.5 millimeters. And all you need is some wire. Let me demonstrate. Here there's a hole. This hole is if you need the loop to be if there's tied something over here and you need a specific size, there's the hole that is there, so you can cut it at the size you need. For the time being, it's not needed, so all I have to do is pass this over here, just a little bit. Everything that is beyond this point is going to be cut off, so like that, hold it, and got it. Perfect, and in no time. Let's do it again. Throw it over here and got it. And always you can, the time that you are about to take it out, let me do that again. You can have a perfect loop, perfect ring. Like that. Perfect. Like it came out from the factory. This is Wolf. He's lying on the door and he scratches himself. Perfect ring. And I can do that, of course, with a much thinner wire, and I have the loops that I need in no time. in no time at all. For everyone who wants to get this tool, it's in a link beneath it's in the link of the Amazon link under the description of this video, and you can order it at any time. So give me some moment and I'll get back to you to work on the ship. So guys, this wood strip is a bit different, not so much over here the bow, but it's going to be a bit different over the stern, and I'm going to show you why. So give me a moment. First of all, let's make the bow to fit. This is going to be a little bit difficult. Hard part is to mark it correctly. Okay, let's bend it. All right, got it. Now, let me show you, let me take some measurements so I can put it on and be able to film it, and I'll get back to you. Now, let's see what's happening over here. If I keep doing that, like that, over here you can see I have something that is not right. The board is coming up with a curve that goes outside. This is a mistake. So what I need to do now is do exactly what I did the bow, change the way of planking, but I'm not going to change it, I'm just going to adjust it. So this strip, as you can see, if I was putting any pressure on this strip will go like that. You can see that. And this is the way it will go. So, the first point of contact is here. And the strip ends up right here. And now we have to cut it. And we're going to do that with an angle. We're going to cut it like that. Not like that, like that. Now let's glue this. This is the hard part over here, the bow. Let's see now. My fingernail glued on. Let me unglue it. Now let's continue. I have it glued underneath here. So let's do that. All right. Now, let me put a couple more and I'll meet you when I hit this point. All right, I've reached the point that I was talking about. Here I have the strip. Let me glue it up to this point and I'll get back to you to do this one. All right, now let's glue this. Okay, let me remove the tripod and I'll give you some tips. All right, now let's begin from the bow. You can see here the wood is making a curve upwards. It's visible. This is because you see here we have this distance and here we have this distance, so this means that from now on and up to the closing of the hull, from this point and better from this point and all the way to the bow, this must be tapered and we have to make it thinner, otherwise this will be more intense and then we're going to have a problem. This doesn't apply to the stem. Let me show you something. Now, you've seen here that I have made the wood twisted a little bit and glued over here. We have two scenarios. First scenario is that you won't be using any copper plates, so you're going to use only paint. You can either cut this part here later on and make a straight line, or you can add a little bit, a piece of wood over here and sand it and make it to end over to this point here. This is my that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to sand it and ending it to this point over here. Now that I'm thinking it again, I will see, because I will use copper plates. If you use copper plates, of course everything is going to be covered. I believe up to this point here everything is going to be covered. So over here you have to make it either the first way, leave a small gap unplanked, or plank it all and just sand it to make it finishing over here. I believe the scenario of planking and finishing over here is much better looking. After all, everything is going to be covered, but it's much better looking. And over here, I will see when the time comes. I haven't made my mind yet, because this is different. This is the piece of wood that we normally throw on after the hull is fully planked, but this piece is already exists here, so it must be separated and look like that. I will definitely use the wood strips like that. I will plank them all the way and maybe I will clean them to leave a straight line. Maybe that's what I'm going to do finally, now that I'm thinking better, because over here we have the kill also. The kill is already in position, it's part of the main skeleton. Okay, this is how I am going to work. Now I will see you again when we reach the point of closing the hull. It's not far away, as you can see the ship is almost done, the hull that is. It's not far away, so in our next video we're going to close up the hull. It's not going to be difficult, but it's going to be tricky. So guys, thank you very much for watching. Don't forget the Super Thanks ability, and I hope to see you in our next video as well. Take care.